Hello and greetings from Iceland, but here we go again. Yet another earthquake swarm has just started. And again, it's on the westernmost part of the peninsula, but this time the earthquakes line up between the island Eldey, that sits on the mid-Atlantic ridge. And since it's Eldey, it gives me a chance to merge two stories into one, since on this small island, or rock out there, we have the home of the largest Gannet colony in Iceland, and I do have bad news from there. But before we cover the birds, let's start with their home, this little rock that is only 77 meters high and one of the youngest part of Iceland. An underwater eruption during the 13th century is responsible for its existence, but the island was born during the last serious episode of unrest on the peninsula. But I have mentioned this before on my channel, when islands come and go around there, or in some of my older videos about this location, and I'm linking to them for those of you who are new to my channel. Foreign fishermen used to call this island in the old days the flower sack, but the Gannets had more respect for the rock and settled there. But around 30,000 pairs of Gannets breed in Iceland, and over half of them do so on this rock, making Eldey one of the biggest Gannet colony in the Atlantic. And just yesterday, we learned that the bird flu has been confirmed in habitats of Icelandic migratory birds at four locations. But it's still spring, so this is just the beginning. Not the first bad news, I would think, since it's a bad flu out there now. And one of the infected birds was a Gannet that they found not so far away from the island, Eldey. And what we fear now is that the Gannet colony in Eldey is at some risk. But a few years back, an online webcam was placed there, and I'm of course linking to it. And what worries us now is that we do not only see dead birds in the live cam this year, the island doesn't seem to be as densely populated as we have seen for the last years. So this is something that we are looking into now. But since this just came up, I can't say more until our experts have done more research, and I'm sure it's a priority now. But let's move back to the geology. The island sits on the plate boundaries, a part of a cluster of rocks and skerries, extending 85 kilometers out from the mainland. And this is a relatively unstable and unsafe ocean area, with however rich fishing grounds. But every now and then, we get the catch of the day fully cooked from the ocean, since underwater eruptions around there are quite frequent, and we don't even notice them all until we get freshly boiled lobster in lightly salted water with a dash of a natural sulfur taste straight from the ocean. But after the island Eldey was formed during the 13th century, the action didn't stop. There are tales of activity in 1582, then again in 1884, and even 1926, or unrest that might tell us that underwater eruptions are more frequent than we think. But those events occurred only around the island, which is only 15 kilometers away from the mainland. But further out, somewhere around here, we got a new island in 1783. And what makes that island stand out, even though it was gone within a year, is the fact that this eruption occurred the same year when the Grímsvötn system erupted big time. The 1783 eruption in Grímsvötn turned out to be the deadliest eruption during historic times here in Iceland, or when this huge fissure from the Grímsvötn volcano, Ánder Vatnajökull glacier, opened up, or the famous Lucky Row of Craters. So I have seen this question pop up every now and then while browsing for information. Or does the Grímsvötn system connect somehow to the activity on the mid-Atlantic ridge, and how? And I have to add that there is growing unrest in Grímsvötn now. An eruption will take place there soon, according to our scientists. But don't worry if you are a tourist. It's Iceland's most active volcano system, and we should simply be grateful for the fact that Grímsvötn eruptions have been both frequent and harmless for the last decades. But there is, however, always some risk for the air traffic though. But then, Grímsvötn eruptions can be over and done with in a matter of few days, and greenshot and eruptions nowadays do all take place under the glacier. And there are no hotels there yet. And one of my next videos will be dedicated to the highlands and what's going on up there now. And today's video is just a small detour. But I am, however, seeing the situation from 2021 up here again, or to see my plan for the day change as I wake up and check the seismometers that tend to provide me with new storylines almost every day. And that is the overall situation now. The activity on the plate boundaries is picking up, and I have been wondering where the next eruption would come up. My first guess was Eldey Gannet again, or a bit further east in the Krýsuvík volcanic system where things are actually still shaky. And my third guess was the westernmost part of the peninsula, even offshore, so in the light of the most recent developments around here, it is a good idea to keep this area under the radar. See what Mother Earth has in the pipes for us this time, because if those pipes will lead to the seabed this time, we are in for a show of a lifetime, and the Keflavík International Airport will be useless for a while, leaving us with only two small airports to handle all the air traffic to and from Iceland. But I am of course just speculating now. At least I can say that things have started to move again, and I'm very curious to see the next INSAR data or any new land uplift. I also want to mention that when we get those earthquakes on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, or the Reykjanes Ridge, as we prefer to call it as it enters our territorial waters, they are often accompanied by earthquakes on the peninsula, so I will be on the lookout for the next days. This might of course just fade out, but due to other earthquake spike we had just a few days ago and I spoke about in my last video, I have the feeling that the unrest we are seeing now might pick up like in last December, and it might even be the first signs of the next eruption. So as always, it's quite exciting to live here in Iceland, and we hope for the best when it comes to locations. And I will be going south soon since I need more footage around there, but I have the feeling that I will need it very soon. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.